Steve. It's Kirk and Gerry in Boston. How are you?
Good morning. This is the second call I've gotten this morning from Boston. You know, the first one was from someone from Tom Marino's office. I think the governor or the mayor's office saying we should, everybody with New York cars over the weekend would have to move them because they're planning the Stanley Cup parade route. Something, did I miss something, or is the series still going on?
Well, we're not thinking that they will get by Pittsburgh too easily, but they'll play Pittsburgh. You disagree, Steve?
It's going to be awfully tough to win 4 out of 5 from Boston. Absolutely.
That's
and I
well,
blame
well
the
put.
Two Boston area coaches on the Rangers, Tortorella and Mike Sullivan. Mike Sullivan, perhaps the worst power play coach in the modern history of the NHL.
I was going to ask that because Mike Milbury obviously went off pregame Sunday and said it's time to blame the coach. He's had a lot of talent. The coach is. You're right. Absolutely. The coach is.
And I'm not, listen, if you guys read my stuff or you watch the games, I'm not a big Tortorella fan. But I think some of the blame has to move over a little bit. It's not a one-man show. I mean, it is visibly because he's on the air and he's ostensibly the face of the franchise, as you guys know, without Glenn Sather, you know, without the GM talking very much. So he gets a lot of the blame, and deservedly so. Listen, I wasn't impressed by either team in the first round. Clearly not the Rangers, who basically had to get 2 shutouts to beat Washington. And if the Bruins had collapsed, I mean, boy, it was like fire everybody, trade everybody. All of a sudden now, Stanley Cup?
Do you get the sense that Tortorella's coaching for his job here in this series?
No, not at all. Did pretty well last year. And we seem to have short memories now in media and sports and the world, the whole thing.
More
perspective.
Power play aside, Steve, what is your opinion of Tortorella as a coach overall? I mean, you said he did pretty well last year. It's been 9 years since he won a cup. I think he's 11 games under 500 in the postseason since then. Is he a good coach?
I'm not a player, so I can't really tell. I don't know what goes on in the locker room. Some players like him, some players don't.
Right.
I clearly think he could be a better coach if all we're going to do is go by stats. And yeah, listen, guys, it is a results business. There's no doubt about it. I think his personality can be disruptive, abrasive, confrontational. A lot of coaches win like that. Bill right. Parcells, you know, in other sports. I mean, is Tortorella Vince Lombardi? No.
Does the style work over the long haul, the shot blocking, the grinding it out, mucking in the corners, does that take something out of a team when it comes time to score a goal or two?
Sure, I think so. I mean, I think the team needs to play a little bit more free offensively. I think they're worried too much about playing defense. On the other hand, you know, again, as you guys know, each playoff series is like a mini season unto itself. And it's really hard to make predictions. God knows, you know, how hard is it to make predictions at the beginning of the season? I'm probably about 50%. You know, I leave the gambling to the professionals, but, you know, I can't imagine that anyone picked the Islanders to get into the playoffs this year, that Toronto would give such a hard time to the Bruins. You know, Ottawa with all the injuries they had. So you can never tell, but clearly, you need to score goals to win.
For more, visit WEEI.com/video.